Go to stufftoblowyourmind.com to enter the Science Awards contest and a chance to win a $10,000 college scholarship sponsored by BASF, the chemical company. You know what's better than a 3D printed pizza? Nothing. Nothing in the world is better than a 3D printed pizza. Sorry, everyone else, just pack up and go home. Hey guys, Tara here for D News with a story that is sure to warm the cockles of even the coldest, deadest heart. I don't know if that's a word, but I just said it, so now it is. A group of engineering students from an Illinois high school used a 3D printer to make a prosthetic hand for a 9-year-old girl who was born without fingers on her left hand. A regular prosthetic hand costs up to $50,000, which is an insane amount of money. So instead, the girl's father approached the school asking for help. Students found a 3D printout online that can be used to create fingers, and then they pieced the hand together, adding flexible cords that allow it to bend and grab things. The girl now has a brand new functioning hand, and the total cost? $5. Damn it, I love a good bargain. Of course, this isn't the first time a 3D printer has created working body parts, and it's actually probably more common than you think. Last month, a group of doctors in Holland performed the first successful skull transplant using a plastic 3D printed skull. It's insane. The patient who received it suffered from a condition that thickens the bone structure, causing headaches, blindness, and eventually death. The procedure took around 23 hours total, and the woman has now completely regained her sight and return to work. Absolutely incredible. And here's a weird one, 3D printed eyes. A company called Fripp Design and Research in the UK prints up to 150 prosthetic eyes every hour, and obviously they don't work the same as a real eye, but they are significantly cheaper and more readily available than standard glass eyes. The same company also produces an array of other facial prosthetics, including noses and ears. What they do is scan a patient's face and then 3D print a perfect replica using starch powder, silicone, and pigments. Not only is it cheaper than leading prosthetics, it's more patient-friendly because it doesn't require a very invasive facial mold to create. Very cool. The Wake Forest Institute for Regenerative Medicine is another place that's leading the way in 3D prosthetics. They recently created a bioprinted kidney by depositing kidney cells cultivated from a biopsy into a biodegradable shell. The kidney is then incubated for a few months and then transplanted into a patient, so as the functional tissue inside grows, the shell outside slowly degrades. Wake Forest has also paved the way for synthetic skin grafts, and they are currently developing a printer that could print skin straight onto the wounds of burn victims. First, they use a scanner to determine the size and depth of the wound, and then they use an ink made of enzymes and collagen and layer that in between tissue and skin cells the same way it would be layered in healthy skin. They say their goal is to have portable skin graft machines ready within 5 years so they can use it on soldiers who have been burned in war. It may be another decade or so until we see 3D printed kidneys or other major internal organs put into humans, but let me reiterate just how incredible the potential for this is. Transplant waiting lists would be a thing of the past. Lose your arm in a boating accident? It's cool, bro, I'll just print another one. And better than any of that, it brings us one step closer to being cyborgs. If you can think of any use for 3D printers that is cooler than things I just listed, I want to know about them. Leave your comments down below, and for more episodes of D News, subscribe here.